am I talking about an angry God? No, I'm just giving you the whole counsel of God on this matter. Now, hear me well, let your ears be circumcised today. We cannot emphasize what God does at the expense of who he is. Like it or not, God hates sin, but he loves men the most. Understand? God's hateness for sin will never change, no matter how much he loves you. No matter how much he loves you. You understand? He still hates sin. Because sin is an offense against his holiness. Now, in its essence, sin offends the holiness of God. And God is so holy. The most outstanding attribute of God is his holiness. He always appears in his holiness. That is the outstanding attribute of God, that he is a holy God. Amen. And so now, we do not emphasize what God has done at the expense of who God is. So now, yes, God is love. God is love, and he is the God of love. But let us look at the love of God in his context. In Genesis, we didn't see love. He was just creating. Amen. In Genesis, we did not see love. We just see God creating. Our creator. He makes man. And after making man, man finds himself in sin. And when man finds himself in sin, the wrath of God is invoked. And God wants to execute his wrath on man. But when God wants to execute his wrath, the love of God compels him, because I still love man. So the love of God is the only thing standing before the wrath of God and us. It is his love. That's why the Bible now says God is slow to anger, because of his love. So the love of God withheld the punishment for some time. That's why the Bible says in the fullness of time, because that's how long the love of God withheld the wrath. So but the wrath, it needs to stand up to defend the holiness of God. So in God, in his justice, he must defend his holiness. That's why he must punish sin, because he hates sin, and man has sinned and God has spoken. So now God now needs to redeem man, and his love is revealed in saving man. So the love of God we speak about is a saving love. So he's there to save us from sin. Listen to what the Bible says. The Bible says love covers a multitude of transgressions. Why are you missing the picture? Love is there to deal with the sinfulness of man, because love covers a multitude of transgressions. You cannot speak about the love of God while promoting sin. That is error, because love in itself is there to deal with sin. And the love of God covers a multitude of sin. So God in his love covers sin. Remember, the Son is love. The Son is propitiation. Remember the language of salvation. Propitiation is salvation. What is propitiation? Propitiation is atonement covering our sin. That's what love does. It's an atonement. It is a propitiation, a cover for our sin. It's a cover. So love is a cover. Love is revealed to deal with the sin problem.